Namaste. Welcome to yet another episode of Accomplished Women by Thought Habitats. So this is our 20th episode, and we interviewed two large academicians in the country who excelled in rural education and women empowerment all these years. And then we interviewed a lot of women entrepreneurs, and at last we interviewed a social entrepreneur who is at a young 20. Now, on the similar lines, we have another social entrepreneur who is pretty experienced, but she's still young in terms of her achievements. We have Ms. Devangi Dalal, who's an audiologist, speech therapist, and a social entrepreneur who is working towards eliminating societal stigmas over children suffering from hearing impairments. She established Josh Foundation along with Mr. Jayant Gandhi, which is a movement towards curing hearing impairment in children, and they are solving the societal stigmas towards these children. How do they do it? That is by leveraging advanced medical technologies and inculcating rehabilitation programs for these children. You know, long back, her achievements were recognized. The American Academy of Audiology in 2012 felicitated her with the Humanitarian Award, and she is among the few Indians who got this award. So, without much delay, Devangi, welcome to the show. And
thank you.
You know, societal stigmas is a very big issue as on date. And as a medical professional, you're working towards it, which in itself is a larger achievement.
Thank you very much for inviting me. And it's a great initiative by you that you are coming up with all issues and trying to, you know, give awareness among the people. And thank you for making me part of it.
Right. Devangi, I have a few questions. You know, you have a bachelor degree in audiology. So a career in audiology was already inevitable. But choosing hearing impairment among children and working towards it as a social cause, how it all started?
So I started with in 1991, that is 30 years back, started working with ENT surgeon Dr. Jayant Gandhi, where I used to see the patients medically. I used to also assist the operations and see that what exactly, you know, pathological problem and physiological problem the patient go through. And I was also attached to one institute where we were dealing with only hearing impaired children. And in 1993, the technology came in the hearing aids, where you can, like how individual eye, you can select the number and you give the spectacles like that. In 1993, the technology came that you can fit the hearing aid according to that individual's requirement. So every person who has a hearing impairment, they have a different hearing, like some may have 5%, 10%, 15%. So in 1993, the big revolution came in the hearing aid industry, where you can program the hearing aid to an individual's requirement. And over the years, in 1998, the digital technology came in the market, like how you have a digitalization in the computers, phones, and all other electronic devices. The same way, the technology came into hearing aids. So where you can enhance the speech and you can reduce the noise. So the basically anybody who receives the hearing, they receive the signal, speech signals, bypassing the noise signals. So that kind of technology got introduced in 1998. And I was working with the institute, I was working with the ENT surgeon. And we used to find out that how best technology can help these children. And I also used to look at the rehabilitation part. So over the years, I saw that there was a tremendous change was coming in these children. You know, if they are given, they are done proper diagnosis, if they are given the right technology, if they are given the right rehabilitation, they can achieve like a normal people. So that's how, you know, working with them, I understood that I can make a lot of change in this lives, you know, hearing impaired people. And today, like if 30 years of practice, if I go through so many children, like who have, I have detected the hearing at the age of 9 months, 1 year, and today they are entrepreneur, engineers, sports management program. So I feel that, you know, the kind of skills I have, the kind of potential I have, you know, working with hearing impaired children is able to help the lives of so many people. And basically this hearing impairment is not seen. So not much work done on it. So if, and we can reduce the liability from the country because you can make them self-dependent. So why not do that? So that's how in 1998 onwards, you know, the whole process started. And whatever came on the way, learning, researching, learning technicals, helping them, finding out their problems, you know, how best I can take out potential from there, all started happening. And now it is just multiplying. So it just that happened through the experience and the process.
That's really interesting to know. You know, so much happens around. And Devangi, secondly, there must have been challenges, right? So you say I did research and whatever came my way, I took it. But nothing comes easy, right?
Yes.
So similarly, what were the most pressing issues for you throughout this entire experience?
So first of all, in 1998, when we started, you know, working with the hearing impaired children to accept the technology for the parents or any NGOs or government, it was very difficult. And I used to feel that we are implementing the technology in everything, but why we are reluctant to use the technology for the hearing impaired people? Like today, even if you see for you know, visually impaired, we have a Braille and we have a lot of curriculums. But for, you know, hearing impaired, there is not much work done. So if one starts working on it, then a lot of things can be done. So one is the misconception about the hearing impairment. Second, people were not aware that, you know, that every child has some hearing. Like in my 30 years of practice, I have not seen anybody having no hearing. They have 5%, 10% hearing. And with the technology, you can get it, like even normal person has a hearing between 90 to 95%. So with the technology, you can reach up to level of 80, 85%. So if the right technology given to them, they can achieve at the earlier age and achieve the best. So another thing is that to understand and implement the technology is again a problem. And even the social stigma, you know, that wearing a hearing aid, why I have to wear the hearing aids? Like it's easily acceptable, the, you know, eyeglasses, you know, wearing the spectacles. But as far as the hearing aid is concerned, it's not acceptable, not even by the parents for their children and as an adult also. So, these are the issues, and plus through the government in US, UK and all other countries, 80% the children who leave the hospital, they are screened for the hearing. And it is done in almost 80 countries, but in our India, it is still not there. So to make a professional understand that they have to go to the neonatal screening, and you know, the earlier you find out the hearing impairment, you can give them the right technology and do the right rehabilitation so that they can overcome it. So these are the issues, like as far as awareness point of view, the major issue. Like even we were visiting the special schools and we used to tell them that, you know, all the children should be fitted with the right hearing aids. And they are over the years teaching them sign language, gestural language. And it was so easy task for the teachers also to teach them. So to fit the technology and give the curriculum or teach them in a different way was also unacceptable. I remember in one of the school I visited and I fitted the hearing aid to everyone, and the trustee was very keen that, you know, every child should be given a right hearing aid and right rehabilitation so that they can be integrated in the normal schools. But then teachers were not ready because they were feeling that, you know, with the technology, you know, if they are not able to achieve a good results, you know, the management will, you know, throw them out, you know, or will not work with them. So they were reluctant that, you know, we will not work this with this children. And I told them that you work for 6 months, you see that with the technology, you'll be able to do work very easily with them. And if you feel that you are not comfortable, I'll take all the hearing aids back. And it so happened that after 6 months, they all started doing so well that, you know, they don't have, like, their 2 years of working with them reduced to 6 months working. So now it is easier for them to accept it. So every step, of course, even, you know, we invest so much money for the electronic devices, but for giving a hearing aid, digital hearing aids to the child, spending 50,000-60,000 rupees per child also is not acceptable. They say that 5,000 hearing aids are available. We can give it to so many children. Why you want to give a 60,000 hearing aid to the child? But I said, if by giving a right technology, using them for 7-8 years is changing the life of a person, why not do that? Make a quality of hearing for them. So even that was very difficult because all the nonprofit organization, they were so used to, you know, having hearing aid of 5,000, 10,000 and giving to so many people. And I am the person who is saying that, you know, per child, you know, spend 60,000, you give them a right hearing aid and, you know, teach them a good technology and, you know, make them achieve like a normal people. So it was very difficult throughout the process because there is not much awareness on this. And what I did is the first thing what I did is that I developed the results and working on some children. And now seeing the results, it is getting multiplied. Now people have understood, of course, technology makes a difference. So now, till now, through the Jewish Foundation, we have helped 1,300 underprivileged children.
Wow, that's really nice. That's quite an achievement. In fact, that partly answers the next question also. Yeah, so what do you consider as the biggest achievement so far? As you say, 1,300 underprivileged children have been benefited out of it. So on the similar lines, what more you consider as the biggest achievement so far of Jewish Foundation?
Biggest achievement is that working with the hearing impaired children, you know, today in pandemic, you know, we are getting panicked. We are worried about your health issues. You know, what will happen? What will be our future? And I looked at these specially abled children who from the birth, you know, they struggle for themselves, you know. So they don't have any options, you know, whatever you do for them, they have to accept it. If you include them in the part of society, they will get included. If not, they will leave the isolated society also. So working with this specially abled children, I feel at each and every stage, I have changed myself. I have become a better human being. And recently in pandemic, I started writing articles from my experiences working with disabled children. And I published a book called Spreading Positivity. And I write the blogs on the, you know, Google, so that, you know, every child who inspire me can inspire other people. So I think biggest achievement working with these children is that I have become a better human being. One. Second thing is that, you know, we have, if you count in the world, 360 million people, out of that 6.3% population is hearing impaired. The similar, we have a 130 million people, we have 6.3% population who is hearing impaired. Out of that, 40% are children and 60% are adults. And out of that population, only 10% is getting a proper treatment to their requirement. So it's a huge work, a huge requirement working with these children. And today they are the liability for the country. So if I work in the direction what I've been working, and if I can change the life of people and make them self-dependent, so that they become a natural assets, you know, I'll be the happiest person to do that. And then through the American Academy, when I received the award, you know, the biggest achievement was in my life is that I was representing my country. And I was a role model for other people, you know, who also run the organization. So that is the biggest feeling that working with this hearing impaired children made me achieve. So which I will never forget in this life, you know, those 4 minutes where I was supposed to receive the award and give the, you know, speech about how I feel, you know, working with this hearing impaired children. So that's something will always remain, you know, in my memories.
That's really good. So, Devangi, one last question. So much happening, 3 decades of assisting hearing impaired children. So, and winning a humanitarian award and becoming a better human day after day. So, what next? What's the roadmap for Josh Foundation and your personal career in the days ahead?
So as a Josh Foundation, we want to reach it at the national and international level and try to change the life of a hearing impaired people, you know, how much we can. Because today, even if you say at a national level, the hearing aids are given in a standardized level, you know, they are not given to an individual's requirement. So till now, we have helped 1,300 children, but there are so many people to help throughout the country. So we would like to reach at each and every part of the country and try to help, you know, whatever best we can as far as Jewish Foundation is concerned. Even in Jewish Foundation, we run a sports education program, a lot of skill development, because we feel that not only diagnostic, not only rehabilitation, but there are overall development of the hearing impaired children is also required like a normal people. So we are working on them to develop their skills in best possible manner. So this is one thing, and as a personal level, I feel that, you know, working with these children, you know, many a times normal people feel nervous to talk to, you know, 1,000 people who are, you know, there, you know, who is listening to you. And I have trained my children so that they can speak like a normal people in front of 1,000 people. So I, as an individual level, wants to develop a voice training program and public speaking classes, especially for the hearing impaired children. That's my personal wish. And to develop an institute where hearing impaired children, their diagnostic, rehabilitation, their vocational training, matrimonial or employment, anything is there, which is available under one roof. You know, they don't have to run here and there to find out the solutions for them. So this is something which, you know, we have dreamt of and we are working on it.
That's quite a dream and quite a lot of work happening. And all I can tell you is all the best for all your future endeavors. And, you know, definitely each one of us have a role to play in cordoning off the societal stigmas of a hearing impaired children. You know, we have to be inclusive. They need to be included in the society and treated like normal individuals, like how we treat our friends and family members together. So hats off to all your work, Devangi, and all the best for all your future endeavors. And I hope to see that 6.3 and 40% of the children whom you said would definitely get benefited sooner or later with your work.
Yes. I think working with them and including them into the special society will only, you know, give a best result as a beauty of kindness, you know, in this world. I think we should do all that because even if you change the life of one specially able children, I think you have done a good kindness, you know, in your life. So I request all who are listening us that if you come across any hearing impaired children, guide them, show them the right path and make them the part of the normal society.
Definitely.
Thank you.
And I'm sure our viewers would do it. Thank you so much for joining with us, Devangi, and all the best for all your future.
Thank you so much. My pleasure.